Good morning from Castaway Cay. Today we have a sun-filled day and a fun-filled day with bikes that we have rented. We go snorkeling, we will have lunch here. So
we'll take you guys along and explore the island.
Yes.
Let's go. Look at her.
Look at her being majestic.
Yeah.
We're really walking onto a tropical island.
We'll
just walk all the way across the beach and then find a place around Cay here. So we can go snorkeling from there. And I think the bike rental is also somewhere over there. So gonna be fun.
Nice. That's cute.
$1 extra, but I thought, yeah, this is just really nice.
One pin in there.
Yeah, just one pin.
Yeah, nice.
To commemorate our first Disney cruise.
Yeah.
First of many.
Indeed.
Ooh. Pretty hot walk.
Yeah.
But we're almost at the end now. I think we are, right next to us is Cookies Too, the restaurant where we have lunch. We wanted to walk a little more to the back.
Yeah, that's so, the back of the family beach though.
Yes,
you can go way further to the adults, but that's way out there.
Yeah, normally we would maybe go to the adults only beach, but we rented the snorkeling set as well. And you can snorkel at the adult beach, but over here there's a lot of nice things to discover on the water.
Yeah.
And we all bring the GoPro with us on the water as well, so you can also see it if we find it, of course.
Yeah.
We made it to our spot with the very blue sea.
All the floaties.
All the floaties, and to the left, all the bikes.
All the bikes. It's the Netherlands. Did we transport to the Netherlands?
Well, you will feel right at home now, right? Yes, Becky boy. I got my bike as well. So let's hit the road.
The private island of Disney themselves, but we learned from the nice presentation that they actually have a 99-year lease on the island.
Yes, and therefore they're not allowed to use a lot of it. I think they could only use 15% of it.
Yeah, so 15%, 15, and you can see that all the back of the island here is not really used. It's all like swamp land.
Which is probably why they are working on the second private island.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if that is their own, but it probably is. The tower is wobbling.
Yes,
get down the tower. Oh, that's really nice. You guys should rent the bikes for sure.
Yep.
And then get back here, because it's quite a way walking, and with the bikes you're there in maybe 5 minutes. Or
there's also the 5K that you can do.
Yeah, no, don't do that. No.
Well, you can, but you don't really need to run it, I think. Yeah. Because a lot of people just walk in the 5K.
Yeah, and then if you complete it, you get a medal, I think.
Yes, maybe. So I would do it for the medal.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
We will go back on the bikes now.
Yep, so.
Let's go.
Be Dutchies again.
And now we're back on the landing strip again, cycling in the direction of Serenity Bay. As you can see, this is also where the tram turns around. Bike and hike to the right.
back at the adult beach part. Just gonna grab a drink real quick from the hot bicycle ride. It's really nice though, but sweaty too. Came back from the snorkeling.
Yes, we did a lot of snorkeling. It was really nice to snorkel over there, but it was also really tiring.
Yeah.
The nice things that you could see were pretty far out,
yeah.
So you had to pedal over there.
And
pedal all the way back. Especially the way back was tough, but it was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Right now we will have lunch.
Yeah.
At Cookies Too.
Yes. And we'll see how that goes.
Yes, I'm hungry.
Yeah. Got the Cookies Too BBQ. It's gonna open in a bit in the afternoon. Plenty of seating area, nice and shaded. Some nice music in the background. All the island vibes.
Some really nice lunch with some potato chips as well. We've got chocolate chip cookies.
Yes.
And burgers and salads. Oh, and a hot dog. Nice. Lunch also done.
Yeah.
And it was a snack lunch, of course. We had some burgers and some salads.
Yeah, hot dog.
Hot dog. Potato cookie. Chips. Joe's still eating his cookie. And now I think we will grab our stuff and go back to the ship. Because we want to be back for the
tour
around the ship. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see how that goes.
Goodbye, Castaway Cay.
Oh, it was fun though.
We're gonna take the tram now back to the ship because it's way too hot now in the middle of the day to walk all the way back. And the tram just stopped here, so hopefully we can still jump on.
Freshen up from the Castaway Cay.
Yes, we did a quick shower and a costume change.
Yeah.
And now we're searching for the Meridian.
Yeah.
Where the tour around the ship will start.
Never been there on deck 12, and we have to hurry up a bit. But so if we find it, see you there.
Yes.
Okay, we're gonna head on in to Remy. Yes. Pretty small, very intimate. Now, of course, as well, this is gonna be the more expensive option of the added-on dining. So of course we have Remy over here, and Palo is going to be across from us, which we will be going over to Palo next. But of course, like I said, I want you to look out for our rat friend Remy. First, he's right up here when you walk in, looking at his guest as they go into his restaurant. He's also even in our booth. So we have Remy's ear and his mouth, his eye and his nose. All right, my friends, so we made it to a little bit of the private room here of Remy. Now, it actually is going to be themed after Chef Gusto, so you may see the big G on the carpet here. Now, normally, this room is just used for either small gatherings or even a captain is actually able to dine here. The captain's actually the only person allowed to dine here as far as crew members go. Normally, they'll have a giant rounds table, but essentially, if it's a busier night, they will put more tables in here because they do actually try to get all the guests a view right by the window instead of being towards the back of the restaurant if they can. All right, we're gonna head on out back this way. Of course, Palo, themed after our Italian culture. So actually is gonna be an Italian menu. And why Italy? Well, of course, it's where our first two ships were created. So that's where the magic and the wonder were created, right in Italy at the Fincantieri shipyard, which is why every ship does have a Palo. Now, why the word Palo? Well, it's an easy word to say in all the different nationalities that we have here on board. It's just a four-letter word that does translate to the word pole. Now why pole? Because we theme it after the gondolas of Italy. Mm-hmm. Actually right here in the wine cellar, you're gonna see two of those poles right there. And each of those bottles of wine sit in their very own handcrafted gondola. When you also walked in here, you may have realized this beautiful chandelier. It is all hand-blown glass. It is also supposed to symbolize spaghetti and meatballs. So this restaurant is designed in a very smart way. They actually have it as a theater style design because we have our upper level here our lower level right on down there. And then of course our stage is the view, and not much more has to be said about that, because the view, especially here on Castaway Day, is the best view. Our elevator lobbies are also trying to tell you a story and also trying to prepare you as to what you're about to experience. The carpet design preparing you for Remy, or for Palo, and the top of the mirror design over in Remy. If you mostly see a gold block around the main design, it means you're in the aft of the ship. If you see mostly blue around the main design, it means you're midship. And if you see mostly red around the main design, it means you're in the forward. Also, when you come out of this stateroom, so you're gonna see a 5-point star. So not these stars here, but the ones that are in the hallways of the stateroom. The point of the star is always gonna point forward, where the bottom of the star is always gonna point towards the aft of the ship. Now also too, my favorite part of the carpeting in the hallways is gonna be a globe with four ships. Of course, they are the four ships that we have. Again, apart from the Wish, they haven't added in a fifth ship in that carpet yet. Now also too, there's gonna be three stars on the globe. One for Disney World, one for Disneyland, and one for Disneyland Paris.
I had a nice private tour.
Yes, we had a tour with only 5 people, including us. We learned a lot of nice new things.
Yeah, some details and art on the ship that you normally just pass by.
Yeah,
I liked it a lot.
Really, really glad that we did this.
Yeah. Last dinner time.
Yes, our very last dinner, but we will enjoy it even more.
Yeah, the Royal Palace we're going to at the main atrium. Oh, it's hustling and bustling right now. Love it. Ooh, it's in a corner. Oh.
We have a muffin bread. It's very muffiny. It smells not muffiny, but it is. And we can dip it in the olive oil with lemon thingies. It's amazing. Yes, you want this. Last evening, but we have a window seat to look out into the darkness, and yeah, you can literally not see anything. We just went all the way up after our dinner because we thought that the pub was all the way up, but it was on the fourth floor.
It's all the way
down. So now we're going down again. It's still happy hour.
Yeah, 15 minutes.
And we wanted to check out the beer that they have over there.
They have their own signature beer. Guess what? We're going to get it.
For last night. And now I present to you our final tall animal. I don't know exactly, I think it's a bear or a cat. No, I think it's a bear. It's unbearably cute. Oh, it's fine, Joe, it's fine.
It's the last day.
It's the last night, because the day, even the day is gone already.
Oh, it makes me even more sad to die.
No, but I'm also really happy because we got to experience this amazing cruise.
Yeah, it was our very first cruise.
Yes.
But not our last.
No, definitely not our last Disney cruise.
After the first day, we already decided to go again someday, somewhere. We don't know which ship.
Yes, in the hopefully near future.
Yeah.
But Castaway Cay was great to experience.
It was really fun.
It was really being like a tropical, in a tropical island. Because maybe it is a tropical island.
Exactly. It's like everything you're imagining about a Bahamian cruise. This is the visualization of it.
Yes, the bounty beaches and everything.
And we rented some bicycles. We went quite early in the morning to discover the island a bit. So that was really nice. We also did some snorkeling.
Yeah.
And
which was really tiring, but also really nice.
Yeah, it was a quite intense way to get to the viewpoints underwater. But it was definitely worth it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had some nice lunch there and then came back to the boat.
Ship.
Oh, always. It's late. Ship.
Yes, we came back to the boat. We should not like offend the ship.
No, because it's beautiful. And we went on a tour.
Yes, we went on a guided tour around the ship. And yeah, you have probably seen it. But yeah, it was amazing. We had a private tour.
Yeah, it was
basically
only,
it was only five people.
Yeah, including us. So that was really nice. Some details, some artwork. Yeah, really cool.
Yes.
And
then
yeah,
we saw Believe.
Yeah, the show, last show.
Which was also really nice. It was a very cute story with like as many Disney characters as they can possibly fit into
one
show.
Exactly. Yeah, and it was really humorous with the genie.
The genie.
Is
the genie was great. There were a lot of jokes that were also
current. Yeah.
Current and also like a joke towards Disney themselves.
Yeah, exactly. So,
it was really nice for Disney
fans
to watch.
It was fun. And then we had a nice last dinner at the Royal Palace.
Yes.
It was a quite nice menu too.
Yeah, what did you think about your food?
Yeah, it was nice. The food overall at the cruise was really great. But this time I had a duck for starters and a steak for the main course.
Yes.
You had the at first?
I had, what did I have? Oh, I got a really nice salad with some goat cheese. And it was just really tasty with some olive compote, I think.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was also really nice. And then I also got the steak.
Yeah.
The steak was really good.
Yeah.
It was with red wine sauce.
Mm-hmm.
And that sauce,
yeah,
I said like if I was at home I would have licked my plate clean, but
yeah,
I was in a fancy restaurant, so
Royal
I couldn't
Palace.
Do that.
You couldn't do that.
I couldn't do that in the Royal Palace,
yeah,
of course.
For dessert we had three desserts again. I got some vanilla ice cream with some apple tart and like a more
chocolatey
cake.
Coffee-y,
yeah, it was really
yes,
layered, so it was really nice, really rich.
Yes, and I had a really nice creme brulee.
Yeah.
Which was also, just really good. I think the meal tonight was, I would say, the best one that we have at the...
Yeah.
The pirate one was also really good, the first one as well. Maybe we will make a review video later on.
Mm-hmm.
And we will rank maybe and think a bit more about what we ate, because we ate so much, I don't know right now anymore.
No. And tomorrow is the debarkation day.
Yes.
So we got off the ship at Miami and go back home.
Yes.
But overall, just really short, what do you thought for the first cruise?
It was freaking amazing.
Yeah.
I want to do this every vacation. I probably gonna do this every vacation.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was just amazing.
Yeah, it's really nice. We watched a lot of videos before from vloggers that we follow and saw some reviews and podcasts and everything. But everything that you hear, the Disney service especially, is really there. Our servers in the restaurants were really nice.
Everything was really nice. But we will, like I said, make a separate video,
mm-hmm,
because for now we will end the series here.
Yeah.
But we will make a review video where we will go through everything we did in detail.
All the
and
good
tell
stuff.
You what we thought about it.
Maybe the bad stuff.
Yeah, maybe some bad stuff. No, really, there wasn't really any bad stuff.
Spoiler alert.
Sorry. But some things were a little less. So we will tell you about that as well.
It's just really worth it in my opinion. We're going to do it much more. And we're going to just
sleep.
We're
gonna
leave it
sleep
here
now. So please, if you liked it, like and subscribe, and we will see you in the next video.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.